Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12, it says, from the days of John the Baptist unto now, the kingdom of heaven has been advancing forcefully, and forceful people lay hold of it. They take it by force, and the forceful ones take it by force. That means that God is not just looking for somebody that's got a passive thing that says, Lord, if you want to touch me, you can. Here I am. He's more looking for the person that says, oh, God, you got to touch me. Oh, Lord, I want you to touch me. Lord, I'm just not open to it. I want it. I desire it. I'm asking. I'm believing, God. I want to be forceful. I'm going to knock on heaven. I'm not going to give up. If you don't touch me this time, I'm going to pray even more. I'm going to believe anymore because I'm going to draw on the power of heaven by my hunger and by my faith and by an expectation, God. I am a forceful one. And it says the kingdom of God suffereth violence in the King James because they lay hold of it. Lay hold of it this week. Do not have an attitude, oh, nothing's going to happen to me. Have an attitude, I don't know when, but this is a week in which my life is going to get powerfully touched. I believe in the goodness of God, and I believe in a good Father. Then I believe it's His will to touch me. And I want to tell you something. Your prayer is added to the prayer of Jesus in John 14 through 16, where He prayed that we would be fruitful. He prayed that we would be fruitful with the fruit of miracles, signs and wonders in context, actually, so that the Father would be glorified. Jesus has been interceding for us to have these types of experiences. And may it be in the purpose of the destiny of God that this would be the week that the forceful ones who are here would have heaven rended and the power of God come upon them in a greater grace and a greater manifestation, and there would be an activation of the gifts of the Holy Spirit in a greater measure in your life. In 2 Chronicles chapter 16 in verse 9, it says in the RSV, the eyes of God roam to and fro across the earth, looking for someone through whom He can show Himself strong. Isn't that wonderful? God is looking for people through whom He can show Himself strong. I believe the eyes of God have been drawn to this place today because you are a desperate people, a hungry people. You are a people, a surrendered people, a people hungry after the heart of God, a people full of faith, and you've taken time and money to come here. And with this many of you gathered together, I believe that heaven is aware of what's going on today. God is very much aware of what's going on today, and there's going to be an outpouring of His Spirit. In Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1 and 2, it lists six elementary teachings of the Christian faith. This would be the Alpha course of the first century. And in Hebrews 6, 1 through 2, the writer of Hebrews says he's going to go on to more mature things, not laying again the elementary teachings, the foundational teachings, the core teachings of Christianity. I'm going to go past them, going on to more mature things. And then he lists what are these six foundational elementary teachings. And what we're doing today is one of these teachings. Some people think that what I'm talking about right now is a peripheral issue. It's not heart. It's not the main thing. It's only a side issue. I'm going to say, study the word with me and be a Berean, that what we're talking about today is at the heart of the gospel. It's at the heart of the kingdom. And the kingdom, the gospel is the gospel of the kingdom. And it's at the elementary teachings, and it cannot be ignored. And if we do, we miss out what much of what God has. And here are what the six are. Faith, repentance from acts that lead to death. Faith in God, number two. Doctrine of baptisms, number three. It's plural. There are more than one baptism in the New Testament that's mentioned, and this doctrine says a plural, the doctrine of baptisms. 1 Corinthians 12, 13 is one baptism, the baptism of repentance, for by one Spirit. This is the work of the Spirit. We are born of the Spirit, are we not? When we're born again, we're born of the Spirit. Conversion is the work of the Holy Spirit. It is by the work of the Spirit that we come into Christ. When we become a Christian, the Spirit is given to us, and it's by the Spirit, and we have the Spirit, and we're born of the Spirit, and the Spirit seals us. That all happens at conversion, and that's the being baptized by the Spirit into Christ. For by one Spirit we've all been baptized into Christ, whether Jew or Greek, bound or free, and we've all been given to one Spirit to drink. Then it talks about the baptism by water, water baptism. You shall baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But there's also the baptism, or the filling, they use interchangeably and synonymously, of the Holy Spirit. Now watch this. It's the Holy Spirit who baptizes you into Jesus, but it's Jesus who baptizes you with the Holy Spirit. Because that's one of his titles in all the Gospels. He shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit.